I go down. Slaps clear. On deck for the whole time.
Clear.
On mama's bed, I did it with my own sound. And I got more, they try to box me, and I got my own angles, yeah. I'ma spend the summer
What's going on, everybody? Just got to the gym. So, about to take my pre-workout if I can find a positioning for this camera. So like I said, just got to the gym. Gonna do a typical chest and tricep day. Nothing too crazy, especially because I ain't got a gym partner, so I can't really go too heavy. So I'm gonna make it a hypertrophy day, high reps. Gonna take my pre-workout because I am not feeling it. I honestly was falling asleep on the way home from work. But this is what I'm trying right now. I'm really not big on pre-workouts at all. I honestly don't think they have a time and place. Like, they do wake you up. It does give you a little bit of energy. Some will actually give you a little more endurance to make your workouts last longer. But I'm not a big fan. So I'm gonna take a scoop of this, parachute this bad boy, and then we're gonna get in there. Hopefully I can get the full workout, because this is a smaller gym, so usually it gets pretty crazy around this time. Get this party started. Nice and chalky, just the way I like it. But yeah, this is the BPI Sport. Flavor is actually pretty good. I believe it's the Arctic Ice. I don't know if you can see. Anyways, Arctic Ice, not too bad. Doesn't give me the tingles. I know it's like the beta alanine is what gives you all those fire ant feelings. Not a fan of that stuff. Some people are like crackheads with their pre-workouts. I'm not. I just want something that gives me a little boost, and then I could take it from there. But did that, got everything packed up, so I'll see y'all in the gym.
He traded his guns for love, but he's caught in the crossfire, and he keeps waking up, but it's not to the sound of birds. The tyranny, the violent streets, deprived of all that we're blessed with, and we can't get enough, no. Heaven, if you sent us down, so we could build a plague around, for the sinners to play as saints. We'd be so proud of what we made. I hope you got some beds around, 'cause you're the only refuge now, for every mother, every child, every brother that's caught in the crossfire. It's caught in the crossfire. I trained my life to know why he's caught in the crossfire, and now I'm here waking up to the sun and the sound of birds. Society's anxiety deprives of all that we're blessed with. We just can't get enough, no. Heaven, if you sent us down, so we could build a plague around, for the sinners to play as saints. We'd be so proud of what we made. I hope you got some beds around, 'cause you're the only refuge now, for every mother, every child, every brother that's caught in the crossfire. It's caught in the crossfire.
Got done the workout. I'm just gonna kind of do a walk through pretty much what I did. So the first exercise, when I went in, incline bench press, As always, I like to warm up with the bar. Make sure you're hitting it all the way down. Elbows not too flared out, a little tucked in, but not too tucked in. 45 and a 25 on each end. That was my working set. Like I said, I didn't have a workout partner, so I didn't want to push it too heavy. So I worked my way up and did 3 sets of those. Pyramid myself back down. Right after that, worked my way over to dumbbell incline bench press. As soon as I do a compound movement, I like to work that individual muscle. So I went over to dumbbells. When you do dumbbells, you can obviously get full range of motion with each hand further than you can with a bar, because the bar stops right here at your chest. So if you do dumbbells, you can get past your chest to get full range of motion, and your each hand's working the same amount, rather than if you're using a bar, if one hand's stronger than the other, then you're getting a little more assistance. So that's kind of like why I like to work from a compound movement, such as like a barbell movement, to like a dumbbell movement, so that way I can work each individual muscle. So yeah, went over to the incline dumbbell press, pyramid set it back up. So I started off with the 50s, worked my way up to 70, because that's as high as my gym goes, I know. Worked myself back down. The key thing is full range of motion with any movement. I see a lot of people, they cut themselves short on the movement. I used to do it in the past, and that's why it was good to film myself, because I never really seen it. I felt like I was getting depth, but when I seen the video, especially with squats and bench press, when I seen myself doing it, I wasn't going as low as I thought I was. Quality over quantity. V-bar pull down, that works the long head of the tricep. It's more of like a power movement, so I can stack on a little bit more weight. As I stated before, it's working both triceps, so if you have any type of muscle imbalance, one hand's gonna be stronger than the other hand, so you're gonna get assistance. So one hand's not gonna get that full workout. So right after I did the V-bar, I like to do a single hand cable, just no attachment, just the cable itself. You can angle it however you please. It's kind of whatever's comfortable for you, not everybody's the same. So I angled it how I did, pretty much about right here to my chest, and then just extend your arm out and feel the squeeze in the tricep. The key thing is not to move your arm too much. You kind of want to just move your elbow. You want your joint of your elbow just to pretty much be doing the only movement. And then get, like I said, full range of motion. So extend all the way out. And then, like I said, come back. I did 3 to 4 sets of those. So I did 2 movements for a tricep. Then I went back to chest. And then I did, not every gym's gonna have this machine. So I lean to the side. Like if you go like this, like when you flex, and you bring your arm right here and you flex, you can feel your chest automatically squeeze. So imagine that with weight. I like to pyramid my weights. I'll start off with moderate weight and then work my way down. And then I did 3 sets of those. For my second movement for the chest again, I did the machine chest flies. It works the inside of the chest right here. It's great for that, for a finishing movement. Then, like I said, I did 2 exercises for the chest. Now I work my way back to the final movement for my triceps. Triceps, I did a skull crusher. But I like to do it at an incline. Some people do it on a flat bench. I like to do it at an incline. I feel better that way. I don't know, to each their own. Skull crusher is pretty simple. Just make sure you don't crush your skull. Come all the way down. I kind of let the bar either come right here, or I'll let it go a little bit past my head. Whatever's comfortable for your elbows, because it is putting a little bit of strain on your elbow joints. Right after I did those, I did a superset with a pressing movement to really put emphasis on the tricep and the chest. So it was a good finisher for my chest, and my triceps were pretty much taxed. So it was a good finisher for that. And I did about 3 sets of those. And that pretty much is it for my exercise. Like I said, if I had a workout partner, I'd do a definitely heavier weight and push myself a little bit more. I'm about to head my ass back home, get a post-workout shake, and then me and the girlfriend are gonna go out to eat, I think. And we might do Friendlies or something. I don't know, we'll figure it out. But I'll let you guys know. I'll get a little snippet of my food, so that way you guys are aware of what I eat for my post-workout meal. I'll see you guys in the next clip. It's way out of control. I just feel like I'm the only one not pretending. I'm not out of control. I'm just not in a control. I know I'm the most influential. Smile. So I got a buffalo chicken salad. As you can see, the chicken with tortilla strips, romaine lettuce, and ranch dressing.
And here's the meal. It's a 4 cheese pasta with chicken breast and broccoli. Let's grab.
Bye, Friendlies.